What's up guys, Duarte here with another Marvel Strike Force video, and in this video I'm going to take a look at the teams that I use for the Doom Raid in order for you to complete it by 100%. Okay, so let's take a look at the teams that I use and then a few options of characters that could replace in case you don't have them. Okay, so right now on top I have my Mystic team. And I've played on the middle lane and I've played on the lane on the right, so I'll give options for both of those lanes. So this was the team I was using before for Mystic. This team was very good, a lot of control. With Silver Surfer you could always stop She-Hulk from getting the charges and so on, and you had a nice amount of damage of Doom and of Deadpool. If you wanted a little bit more damage you could put Deadpool here instead, but I prefer to have the extra control with Silver Surfer, even that the team was a little bit slower, but it would perform a lot better. Right now the team that I'm using, it's not so similar to this. We still have Deadpool, but now we also have Cloak and Dagger. And of course with this team is super easy. I don't even have these guys at level 80 and they still perform amazingly. Okay, so I have usually Deadpool, Dagger and Cloak. So with this team you have a lot of sustain, you have a lot of healing, you have a lot of damage, and Thanos with a taunt, and because he has the Isolate Defender or Protector or something at level 3, he always gets the minor defense up, so he gets very tanky, and you have full of energy going everywhere, and it's a lot of fun and very easy to play with this team. You can probably auto on all the nodes on difficulty 1. You should just pay attention on I don't know, second node and on the third node to use the ultimate of Deadpool on Doom and on the first She-Hulk in case you want to make it super easy. But yeah, that was the team I was using before and this is the team I'm using right now. Like I said, these two guys, the new ones, even at level 75 gear tier 14, they are just fine. Okay, so that's for the Doom raids. Now let's take a for the Mystic lane. Now let's take a look at the Tech lane. And on the Tech lane, like I said, I've played in the middle, which is a lot easier, and I've played on the right lane, which is a lot harder. And this was the team that I was using. Vulture is very good together with Kestrel. Kestrel, she applies the defense downs to the enemies, and Vulture, because he always does adjacent damage to the enemies with his special and with the ultimate, you will always proc the passive from Kestrel, making her poke everyone very easily. Then I have Mysterio. He gives deflects to all the Sinister Six, and he can also apply blind to Black Bolt, making the last note especially of the boss very easy. Now I have Dr. Doom here, but if you don't have Dr. Doom, there are a few characters that we can use in order to replace him. Unfortunately, not many of these characters are good, and I think if you are not using the Sinister Six like I'm using right now, there are not many good characters that are going to be good for you. But one character that you should consider, and it has been outside of the meta for a while, but it's a very good character, is Shuri. Now, while the stats of Shuri are not that great, she has less than 300,000 outside HP outside of the raids. In the raids you'll get 40% more HP, increasing her HP by 100,000, and she also gets 20% more armor. She gets a lot more tankier inside the raids compared to when you try it out like on Blitz or in Dark Dimension. Plus, whenever someone goes below 50% HP, she will apply 3 deflects to that ally, and this is very important. Because she is a main healer and because Dr. Octopus is a secondary healer, they synergize with each other and they help each other on their jobs. Now you might want to have Mysterio here so he has more speed, or and put Shuri in the corner so she takes less damage. But this is a very good team that you can use to beat the tech nodes without any problem. Characters like Nebula, Ghost and Minerva, they don't do much, and because you are facing so many black bolts, the characters will die and you will not be able to revive them anyway, so it's just better to have the defense up, the extra energy, especially for Vulture and for Kestrel, and the deflects. From the other characters that we have here available, Ultron, because of the black bolts, is not good at all. And from the other characters that we have available, you could possibly make an AIM team. AIM Security and Scientist Supreme would be great on these nodes, but unfortunately they are not great in other game modes, so I definitely don't suggest you to invest in them. Ghost, she is great for Dark Dimension, but for Raid she is completely trash. Her stats are beyond ridiculous, beyond 200,000 HP, and for the Doom Raid difficulty 1, this is simply just not enough. So yeah, you can use Doom or Shuri, but you should really focus on using Mysterio and Vulture for the slows, the blinds, and so on. Okay, let's continue, let's go for the next one. We have the skill team, and this skill team is very, very good. It one-shots all the nodes, even the last one, but this is probably not the best team. Okay, so let's put all, and let's put skill, and let's go through the characters. So yeah, with Captain America Sam Wilson, we have the defense up, we have the deflects and so on, and that's amazing. We have Mary Hill removing negative effects from the allies that are secret Avengers, and then we have Kestrel doing tons of damage and applying defense down and so on. With Moondragon, she's a little bit slow, and it's nice the healings that she does and so on, and Gamora, she does nice damage as well, but if you are a new player, or maybe you are watching this at a point in time in the game where the Infinity Watch are not so great, Gamora, she's nice, but she does a lot of single target damage, and you can get a lot more damage from other characters. This is the team I use because I invested in these characters, but there are a lot better options, and some of these options I'm going to show you right now. So with Sharon Carter, right away you give to your allies a lot more damage, 45% if I remember correctly. Yeah, all secret Avengers will get 45% more damage, and this is quite good because they actually do some decent damage with their abilities. And you still have Kestrel applying the defense downs. The Sharon Carter, she also applies defense downs, and Mary Hill, she also applies defense downs. So with all these characters, you can do tons of damage with the Kestrel passive. Moondragon, as I said, she's okay, but if you're not focusing on Infinity Watch, which you should, but depends on when you are watching this video, there is other characters that might be very interesting as well, based on the mechanics of the deflects. And these characters are going to be Colin Wing and Jackie Chan. So because of the passive from Captain America Sam Wilson, he will give deflects to both Colin Wing and to Jackie Chan, and both of them will get extra benefits from this. So as you can see, 35% more crit and 20% more block, so you do a lot more damage and you are taking a lot less damage. On top of this, you also have increased healing, increased negative effects removal, and tons and tons of damage coming from Colin Wing. I think she still has the chance of assisting, I'm not exactly sure, but even without it, she does tons and tons of damage, and this team is quite a lot of fun. So this is an alternative team in case you have like a very bad Gamora or Moondragon, you didn't got enough yellow stars or red stars on her. This is an excellent, excellent team for your skill nodes. Okay, so now let's move on to the next team. And on the next team we have the Symbiotes. This is the team that I use for the bio nodes. And the bio nodes are the hardest nodes right now, and unfortunately we don't have many characters available or many characters that could make a difference here. And on top of that, we also have characters that are not compatible with each other. So, for example, if Yo-Yo didn't have a restriction to only have her as a protector on the team, we could make a team around protectors, but unfortunately that's not the case. And you could possibly make a team like this with Black Bolt and with Yo-Yo. The problem is that you have to sacrifice a lot of the Isolates in order to get some healing going on this team, because if your Yo-Yo starts to go down and your Black Bolt, you have no way to bring them back. Before, this team used to be very good, but right now it's not good enough because it doesn't have enough passive healing. Because even the symbiotes on their own, because of the symbiote Spider-Man healing effects, it's not good enough because the enemies, they have so much armor and they resist so much that the drain effect doesn't work as well. So yeah, you have to focus on your symbiotes. Now, there is a possibility that you could do another team, but this is just on theory. There is someone that is subscribed to me that has done this team, and on difficulty zero, the team works amazingly, but I don't know exactly how it works on high end with everyone maxed out, if the team works as well or not. So the team is working around the Inhumans and around Squirrel Girl. So we need Yo-Yo here, and finally the last character is any brawler. I think the best brawler is going to be Symbiote Spider-Man because of the defense down and the stun and the slows, but the team works around here. So we have Miss Marvel getting 50% more HP from Black Bolt, which is insane, and then she also gets drain effects and 20% more max HP from Squirrel Girl. So that's 70% increase on her HP, and she already has very, very nice HP. Plus, whenever she assists, she gives deflect to herself, and when she goes below 50% HP, she'll get defense up as well. This is very good because whenever any of these characters go down, except Symbiote Spider-Man, I think, she will taunt instantly. And because of Yo-Yo and Squirrel Girl, the enemies will always have offense down, so it makes Miss Marvel a very, very good tank. But once again, this is just a team that in theory works. I have no proof that this team works, except this person that is subscribed to me that uses this team and says it works very well for difficulty zero. Their alliance is not doing difficulty one right now, but maybe in the future we'll have confirmation that this team is actually better than the symbiotes. Maybe. 100% speculation. Okay, so that's for the bionodes. So finally we have the mutants, and for the mutants, no surprise, I think you already know that you'll have some kind of Astonishing X-Men. And when I was on the middle lane, on the first two nodes, I would use Longshot and Shatterstar, and then on the other nodes I would use and Beast. So for the first two nodes, the nodes with Sif and with Dr. Octopus, I would use this team, so Shatterstar and Longshot. On the second node with cooldowns, this team wins very, very easy with that node with double Bishop and so on. But if you are starting and you have no cooldowns, then you want to use a team with Kitty Pryde. She's very, very good on these raids, and then you can use or Emma Frost or Mr. Sinister or Iceman. You clone the enemy Bishop, and with that your team becomes incredibly strong. Now for the last node on these different lanes, on the hardest lane, the team that I was using would be Longshot, Shatterstar, and then instead of Beast, I would use Mr. Sinister with Isolweight Striker. The Isolweight Striker increases the damage of the clone, and based on this, you would clone the enemy Longshot, and then you just press auto and you win. It would be very, very easy to do on difficulty 1 with this setup. This is for the middle line, and I think the line on the left. The But on the right side, this team is not necessary. It doesn't work as well as on the main lane. So I like to go with the Beast, like I said, and with Kitty Pryde, and then take whichever character you want. Emma Frost, Phoenix, Mr. Sinister, I don't know, Storm. Storm is also very good on this team. She gives speed up and assist. So it can happen that your characters assist three times rather than just two. And it's a very good option as well. But only if you have like five red stars or higher. Otherwise, I don't recommend that you invest on Storm. So yeah, guys, that's going to be the video. I hope you guys enjoyed my recommendations for the difficulty one on the Doom Raid, so you can easily 100% and start stocking up on that blue Isolate. So if you like the information on this video, like always, make sure you share it with your friends on Facebook and Discord. If you are new to my channel, make sure you subscribe for more Marvel Strike Force content, and I'll catch you guys later.